बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। स्टार्टिंग विद द नेम ऑफ अल्लाह द मर्सीफुल द बेनिफिशियंट। आई बिलीव यू आर ऑल इन गुड हेल्थ, एंजॉइंग लाइफ। मस्ट बी अ लिटिल बिट स्ट्रेस्ड एज एवरीबॉडी इन ऑन द ग्लोब इज बिकॉज ऑफ द पेंडेमिक वी आर ऑल फेसिंग, बट स्टिल आई बिलीव द प्रोसेस ऑफ प्रोग्रेस एंड डेवलपमेंट शुड कंटिन्यू। वी हैव बिन in for the guideline, I must say, the studies of child health and preventive pediatrics. I have uploaded almost six lectures, but the talks are the guidelines I have been teaching you regarding child health and preventive pediatrics. But main thing is that you people yourself need to prepare your notes, study them, and see where we are lacking in the study of those subjects. We have been in the process of study of the problems faced in our society as far as health of the children under 5 years of age is concerned, and we have seen that in developing countries like Pakistan, main thing is the health facilities, the availability of the health facilities, which actually plays important roles. And as far as we have been in the study for community support and the best utilization of the available resources, we have been able to get 12 key family and community practices or points pointed out by our health department in collaboration with WHO and UNICEF to be available for the improvement or the improvement of the children under 5 years of age and reduction in the infant mortality rate, and of course death rate of the children under 5 years of age. We have got now status standard 12 key practices pointed out by our health department and WHO in collaboration with WHO and UNICEF. But the main thing is, the first main thing is that the available data, the available data regarding the community practices and the health facilities in the society, and then is the management or the designing or the planning or the guideline production, producing guidelines for our for the members of our society. Our main focus while studying those subjects will be preparing our good managers, good program designers for the improvement of health of a specified community or of whole of the country. The WHO and UNICEF, I just read it for you, the WHO and UNICEF based on available evidence have identified 12 key family practices, family and community practices that if properly promoted and adopted by targeted communities would potentially contribute in improving child health, survival, growth and development. The babies would be healthy, babies life expectancy will be the early death rate would fall, and they will develop properly. Effective interventions to promote those practices require systematic planning by the health managers, well coordinated use of a combination of channels of communication, the best utilization of the communication channels. Obviously the WHOs are available, the mosques are available, the health centers are available, the dispensaries, the basic health centers, the our rural health centers, the tehsil headquarter hospitals, or those are outdoors are available, the other facilities are available, and we can obviously communicate our problem. The maternal child health centers are available, the immunization centers are available, and then is a close follow-up. Obviously, a close follow-up can only be possible through the help of the lady health workers or the lady health visitors or the medical team sitting on the basic health centers and rural health centers and other dispensaries, monitoring them whether we are correctly directed or not. And finally, the supervision. The supervision, by supervision we mean to say that we have to follow the whole of the society and we have to follow the whole of the system working in that specific area for the improvement of health of the children under 5 years of age. The intervention needs to go beyond knowledge acquisition to facilitate change in behavior. We have to produce the change. We have to guide the mothers. We have to guide the politicians of the area. We have to guide the health practitioners in that area. We have to guide the imam masjid in that area to make their change in behavior so that they can improve the health of their babies. The behavioral changes take time to occur and once initiated need to be sustained over a relatively long period of time. Obviously, this is not a one-day story. This is not a one-child story. So we have to implement certain, start certain behavioral changes as far as the health, the dealing with the children of their mothers, of their families, of their health physicians and of their doctors is concerned. And then we have to sustain those practices. If it is cleanliness, we have to follow. If it is breastfeeding, we have to follow. It is not for one child, it is not for one part of the community, it is not for one family, it is not for one society, it is for whole of the world. The adequate resources must therefore be identified within and outside the community to support the intervention in the long term. I mean to say that management, we are in the course for the management degree, management is not the administration. It is not to administrate something. It is not to order something to be followed. It is the management by definition, the democratic use of the resources, the best utilization of the available resources through democratic means is the management. So the adequate resources must there. I read it again, and now you are in a position to understand that the available resources should be best utilized through democratic way. By conducting, by convincing people, by convincing their mothers, by convincing our LHWs, by convincing our LHVs, by convincing our doctors, health practitioners, that those practices are helpful to the health of the baby. So the adequate resources must therefore be identified within and outside the community. What are the facilities are available? What facilities are available and how we can implement them? By all means, health system working anywhere in the world and particularly in Pakistan with collaboration of WHO and UNICEF is to support the health of the babies, even if they are not in a position of illness. So the I read it again. The adequate resources must therefore be identified within and outside the community to support intervention in the long term. The more actively community is involved, more actively the community is involved and participates in the intervention, the higher is the possibility that this intervention would be sustainable. I mean to say that the politicians, the leaders, the community leaders, the chairman union council, the hakims, the doctors, the health providers, all those are if involved, they are in this process of treatment, in this process of implementation, those practices, they are involved, the imam masjid, they are involved, then this practice will be sustainable and will result in the desired outcome. I mean to say it will be a success in reducing the death rate of the babies under 5 years of age. And if it is just a sort of order from the higher ups, just follow, just implement, then it will be a failure. So the community activation or the community involvement or the community participation is a must for the correct and successful implementation of those key family and community practices. The health system plays an important role in supporting families in their child health care responsibility. We all know that. There is no doubt about that. The health system always follows the capacity building is there, the youngsters are, the young technicians, the doctors, the health providers are being trained, the community people are being gathered at the health center, so they are trained, the mothers are trained, the dais are being promoted, the health workers are being sent to the family, to homes of their family, they promote our people obviously to follow those practices, but still we need more participation from the community and more resources from the health system. Then we start with the practices. First is the exclusive breastfeeding. As I said, the first of the key practices is exclusive breastfeeding, very much important, religiously advised, medically advised. By all means, milk of the mother, the feed from the mother is far better than any infant formula or any prepared formula and any marketed formula for the baby. And we should all promote mothers for the breastfeeding. Every lady should breastfeed infants exclusively for up to 2.5 years and one and a half year to 2 years, but 6 months are far more important. HIV mothers are also counseled for possible alternate to the breastfeeding, maybe some other mother or some other lady feeding their children. Then is the obviously we all know the a little bit about the milk. The milk contains more minerals and more vitamins for the baby than any other formula milk, and it is very much near to the body requirement of the growing human baby, and it has got more benefits than we can expect. The relation between mother and the child, the psychological feel, the psychological protection, the health of the baby, the immunity in the first milk of the baby, the immunity in the long term use of the baby, the health of the baby, the all those, and the mother is safe from the malignancies if she feeds her children on her own milk. There is a sort of a concept that perhaps in some villages or in some underdeveloped areas or illiterate areas that the mother of the milk of the mother may be dangerous, injurious to the health of the baby. There is no evidence, nothing has been found of this nature, and anything I believe which has been advised in the religion can never be against any health key guideline of the baby. Now the question is that some of the mothers, they think perhaps if they will feed their babies, their beauty will be destroyed, their body beauty, body look will be destroyed. There is nothing like it, and if something goes on those lines, still it is very, very much advisable for the mothers to feed their children on their own milk. The results will be extraordinary, and the baby will have good health and will always be in a good status of health for whole of the life. The next is the complementary feeding, actually the weaning, the replacement, the assisted feeding, that should start by 4 weeks, 4 months of the age. A little bit thick things other than milk of the mother, maybe prepared from the milk, maybe from other sources, and the weaning, which we say that the oral feeding replacing milk of the assisting, adding to the milk of the mother, should start not more than 6 months of the age of the baby. It can be started at the 4 months, but still must be started by the start of the 6 months of the age of the baby. The mother should feed their children freshly prepared, energy and nutrient rich complementary foods can be prepared at home. Again, it is the same, I repeat, that the formula products like Cerelac, like Ferrex, like other things are not very much helpful to the baby, rather than destroying their chest, they're creating other GIT problems. Those are not helpful to the baby. Only helpful thing is the homely, freshly prepared food, maybe from the cereals, maybe from the fruits, maybe from the pulses. द मदर प्रिपेयर्ड फॉर हर बेबी, खीर, यखनी, सागुदाना, दलिया, ऑल दोज थिंग्स आर हेल्पफुल टू द बेबी वाइल कंटिन्यूइंग टू ब्रेस्ट फीड अप टू 2 years और लॉन्गर टू हेल्प बेबी गेन नॉर्मल हाइट एंड वेट इन रिमेनिंग पार्ट ऑफ हिज हर हेल्थ. देन थर्ड वन इज द माइक्रोन्यूट्रिएंट्स. आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू इंश्योर दैट द चिल्ड्रन रिसीव एडिक्वेट अमाउंट्स ऑफ माइक्रोन्यूट्रिएंट्स इन पर्टिकुलर ए डी कैल्शियम वाइटामिन सी आयरन जिंक इन पर्टिकुलर सो आइदर इन their diet or through supplementation. If supplementation is there, then we should again have home prepared foods, and if in diet, again the home prepared food supplementation should be of good quality, good reputable companies or international companies, and should be administered according to the given standards and guidelines. But main thing is, if we start the weaning at 4 months of age and we prepare foods from the cereals, pulses and fruits at home, the babies would remain happy and comfortable throughout their life, and in particular their health will achieve a good standard health, desirable health in first 5 years of age. Then is the fourth, very very much important, not very much expensive, not very much painful, not very much exhausting, but have saved many life, saved children from more illnesses, more infections. That is hygiene. We have, by all standards, this again, this is Islamically and religiously, this is for all of us. We have to maintain a good hygiene. There is no doubt about that. The hygiene helps us to save our health. But still, if the babies are kept in good hygienic conditions, their hygiene is maintained, their undergarments, their garments, they replace washing after defecation and micturition, washing after feeding, and keeping them neat and clean would help them attain good health. Whenever I always, as a doctor and as a practitioner, I can tell you on my experience, and most of you will appreciate my statement if they are also involved in the practice of the children, that the most of the illnesses, and particularly the GIT disturbances, the diarrhea, the vomiting, those are related with the hygienic conditions of the baby. When hygienic conditions of the babies are not kept in good standards, the hygiene is not maintained, the cleanliness is not maintained, baby always suffers GIT problems, in particular skin problems, other infections, body infections, other infections, infections in the eyes, infection in the other body parts, infection in the throat, nose, the running nose, the other, all those problems, those are all related with hygiene of the baby, and in particular the GIT problems. So we have to maintain the hygiene of the baby. I read it just for you. Disposal of feces, including children's feces, safely and wash hands after defecation, before preparing meals and before feeding children, and of course the maintaining the cleanliness of the baby after feeding them, after their defecation, after the maturation. Please change their dress 3 to 4 times a day, wash them. There is no problem of purchasing or making them wear expensive clothes. Those should be of the cotton and should be clean. That is important, and cleanliness should be maintained of the children, that we save children from a lot of the infections. Then fifth is the immunization. Obviously non-negotiable, no doubt, immunization is a must for every person living on the globe. In this part of the world, Pakistan is among those countries where 10 diseases for immunization, we have got schedule of 10 diseases, and that is always a must. I repeat, a must. There is no bargain, no deal, no negligence, no question of healthiness. We have to have immunized our babies for 10 diseases for which the vaccination schedule is available, the vaccines are available, the vaccination centers are available, vaccination being done at every center, at small, at large, at big, all centers. So I read it for you. Take children as scheduled to complete a full course of immunization, BCG, DPT, OPV and measles before their first birthday. And after that, the remaining vaccination should be followed for 10 diseases up to 1.5 years of age, and then repeat the booster doses of hepatitis, of polio, of other diseases should be given. So those are the immunization guidelines for you. That is all for today. Then we continue with the remaining points of the IMNCI for the key family and community practices. But meanwhile, I will be looking for your feedback, and you will be guiding me for whatever I can do to improve the conveyance of a little bit of the guideline. I can say learn knowledge, convey a little bit of the guidelines to my students. I have got to take some feed, and I hope you will also be enjoying with a good cup of coffee. Meanwhile, thank you very much. Stay blessed.